Hello students, welcome to our session. And today we are taking our chapter number 7, Things Around Us. In last session, in our last chapter, we have discussed about, we have learned about the changes, chemical changes and physical changes, and which type of change is reversible and which type of irreversible. In this session, we take our chapter number 7, Things Around Us. At your day, when your day start, you will get, you can see different things are available around you. There are a number of different things around us. Let us make a list of these first. How many things, how types of things we have to surround us? Trees, cows, buffaloes, many types of animals also. And then we have also chairs, tables, fans, television. Almost different types of things are available surround us. When we start our day, we can see different types of things surround us. These all types of things, can you find out which type of things are living and which type of things are non-living? In your earlier classes, you have also learned about the types of things which we have surround us. We have different types of things, for example, chairs, televisions, etc. We have lots of things. We can classify, we have to classify these things in two categories, living things and non-living things. You have learned in your previous classes also to classify them. In this our lesson, they have also given some types of ways. Using these ways, we can classify which things are staying living and which are non-living things. We have some characteristics common to living things. In this chapter, we can see they give us some types of characteristics, and using these characteristics, we can classify the things which are non-living and which are living easily. So let's discuss about this some characteristics which are given here. First is eating and feeding. Eating and feeding, you can see the things which are living things, because now we discuss about the characteristics for living things. What type of common things we can see in all living things? In them, first is eating and feeding, the things which is living. Then this type of thing can eat and feed. Eating and feeding is characteristic of living thing. In this characteristic, all living things need food. First the thing, if the thing is living, then this type of thing need food. Plants make their food by their own self or by doing the photosynthesis process. Then animals, animals also need food, but they cannot produce their food by their own self. They depend on another animals for their food. Food gives energy to do work. And all living things need food for doing their work. All living organisms need food so that the processes of life can go on inside them. Different types of processes will be go on inside the body for digestion of the food. So living thing, first characteristic of living thing is eating and feeding. If the thing doing eating and feeding, then we can say this type of thing is living thing. And other characteristic is respiration. In respiration is process, the energy will be produced there. Energy will be produced there, for example, the doing for the growth and movement. In this process, we can the things the thing can be breathing, can be breathe. For example, human being, if we want to live our life, then we need oxygen. We take oxygen in our body and we take out carbon dioxide from our body. All living organism doing breathe system. We can see breathing system in human being also, and also in animals, and also in plants, because these all types things are living things. For example, in human being, you can see they breathe in oxygen and breathe out carbon dioxide. In plants also, they take carbon dioxide and take out oxygen. In animals also, but they use different types of body parts for doing this process. In human being, they use their nose for this system. In water animals, we can see fish use their body parts for breathing system. They use oxygen for breathe in, which are dissolved in water. Plants also use carbon dioxide and take out oxygen while they're doing their photosynthesis process. When we eat food plus oxygen also produce carbon dioxide plus water plus energy. In this process, we can see the energy will be produced. The energy will be produced using the breathing system also. This characteristic we can also see in living thing. Then other characteristic is growth. If the thing is a living thing, then it can be growth, their body, their shape, their size. Non-living thing cannot grow. For example, when a baby born, after some time, he or she will become a child. Then he or she will be boy or girl. After some time, adult man or woman. In trees, seed become plant. Plant become tree. Then also egg. Egg become hen or chicken. These type of all things are living things because we can see growth of their body, their shape and size. So growth is also one type of characteristics which we can see in living thing. Then we have excretion. Excretion, that means we use different types of food for getting nutrients, for get energy, for doing work. Some types of food will be digest in our body. Some type will be not digest. Undigested food, which become wastage of food. Wastage of food, if stay in our body, it will be poisonous for our body and also dangerous for us. So the some types of process will be going when our body, the wastage of our body, the wastage we stay in our body will come out from our body using some types of body parts. This type of process is called excretion. This type of process we can all see in human being, also in animals. For example, urine. This is also one type of wastage food which we have in our body. And after doing some processes, they will be come out from our body. In plants, carbon dioxide and water vapor are excreted through small pores called stomata in the leaves. In secretion may be in the form of sticky substances called gum or thick fluid called latex. This is fluid can be seen if you break the twig of rubber plant or a medlar plant. You can see by doing this process. So this type of characteristic we can also see only in living thing. Then reproduction. Other characteristic is reproduction. All living things have the ability to produce more of their own kids. This type of ability we can see only in living thing. They have this type of ability using reproduction. They use this process for reproduct their own babies. The ability to produce young ones of their kind is called reproduction. In reproduction, we can see that some types of animals give birth to their young ones, and some types of animals and birds lay their eggs. For reproduction, using different ways, they doing reproduction process, which are very useful to us. For if animals want to, their life will be going on. For giving their babies, they use the reproduction process. In reproduction process, what happens in the case of plants, like animals, plants also reproduce by different modes. As I say to you, they use different ways for reproduction process. Some of the modes are through seeds, as in pea, gram, mango. Using seeds, we can also reproduce the animal plants using this type of mode. Then through stem cutting, as in henna and rose. That means in some types of plants, we can also get their reproduct by using this type of modes, by seed also, by also cutting their stems, and through stem pieces containing a bud, as in potato. For these all modes, in your textbooks also given the structures, the diagrams for them, the pictures are there. So you can see the pictures easily in your textbook and try to understand more, because always if we want to reproduct, then animals, plants using different modes for reproduction, and reproduction are very important to if we want another life of there. Okay, then our other characteristic is movement. Movement is also possible in living things. Living things show movement. If the thing is living, then it can show the movement of its. Most animals move from one place to another place. Most of animals move from one place to another place and show other body movements. Also show their body movements. If I want to write here anything, then I can up my hand because I am a living thing. So, movement characteristic we can see in living thing. Using these features, they can move their body in the direction which they want. Then other response to stimuli. This characteristic we can also see in living thing. Let us first understand the words stimuli and response. They give response to their body. Changes in the surrounding of an organism which makes it responded to the changes are called stimuli. The organism reaction to the stimuli is called response. For example, if we touch any hot thing, then our stimuli give us notice about them. So we can take our hand from this thing. Then you move your foot. If you suddenly step on a thorn or any of on a sharp object, stone, while walking barefoot, you can feel that. All living thing can feel that. You shut your eyes when you move from a dark place into bright sunlight. These type of things all living things are doing because of the response to stimuli. This type of characteristic we can also see in living thing. Then we have last two characteristic of cellular organization. All things are made by using their cells. Some things are made by single cells and some have more than one cells. All living things are made of cells. In your textbooks, they have also given some examples of cells in the onion, then amoeba, then yeast. You can see the cells which are also given in your textbook as a diagram. A cell is the smallest unit. A cell is the smallest unit of all living things. Some living things are made of only a single cell is called the unicellular organisms, and some have more cells is called the multicellular organisms. But all things are made using by the cells. So we have here some characteristics. This type of characteristics we can see in living things. Using this characteristic, we can classify the things are in living things or in non-living things. Which types of categories? The first is eating and feeding. By eating, they get also nutrition, and living things need nutrients for doing work. Then respiration. Then growth, excretion, reproduction, movement, response to stimuli, cellular organization. These type of characteristic we can see in living things. Using these characteristics, about learning these characteristics, we can easily now classify the things in their category. In which categories? Living things or non-living things. Then we have different differences between living and non-living thing. If we take two types of things, then we can also observe the differences between them. If I take a plant and a chair, now I tell you observe them. You can see the plant and chair. There are many types of differences between them. First, we have discussed about the characteristics about the living things. These characteristics we cannot see in non-living thing. For example, chair cannot eat or feed. Then respiration, growth, excretion. These type of characteristics we cannot see in non-living thing. They cannot grow. They cannot eat, they cannot move by their own self. So these are the differences between the living things and non-living things. Using these characteristics, we can classify them because they have this type of differences between them. Then common between them. Some types of features are also common. That they are made up of basic structures units. In case of living things, cell is the structure unit. In a non-living thing, the molecule is the structure unit. We can also observe them. Some types of features are also same, but main differences, there are lots of differences between them. Differences between plants and animals. Plants and animals, both are living things, but they have also some types of differences between them. What types of differences? First, the nutrients. About the nutrients, plants can make their food by their own self by doing photosynthesis, as we have discussed about this process in our last lessons. But animals cannot produce their food by their own self. They depend on another animals for getting food. Then after locomotion, fixed to the soil. Plants can fix to the soil. They cannot move their place. They cannot go one place to another place. But animals can go easily from one place to another place. Then growth, localized certain regions. We can see the different reasons we have different plants. Diffused in all parts of the body. This type of also, we can also see this type of difference between them. Okay, students? So in this session, we have discussed about the things around us. We have different types of things available around us. We surrounded by different types of things, and all things can classify in two categories. In which two categories? Living and non-living. Then we have learned about the different categories for living things. By learning these characteristics, we can easily classify them in living and non-living. Then differences between living and living. I hope by after this session, now you can easily classify which type of things are living and which type of things are non-living. So our chapter number 7 is finished here. Now we will meet in our next session with our chapter number 8. Till then, take care.